Sisters and brothers, grace be unto you and peace from God our Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. Let us pray for peace and serenity using two stanzas from the hymn, Dear Lord and Father of Mankind. Drop thy still jewels of quietness till all our strivings cease. Take from our souls the strain and stress, and let our ordered lives confess the beauty of thy peace. Breathe through the heats of our desire thy coolness and thy balm. Let sense be dumb, let flesh retire. Speak through the earthquake, wind, and fire, O still small voice of calm. Amen. A reading from the Gospel according to St. Mark, chapter 5, verse 1 to verse 20. They came to the other side of the sea, to the country of the Gerasenes. And when he had stepped out of the boat, immediately a man out of the tombs with an unclean spirit met him. He lived among the tombs, and no one could restrain him anymore, even with a chain, for he had often been restrained with shackles and chains, but the chains he wrenched apart, and the shackles he broke in pieces, and no one had the strength to subdue him. Night and day among the tombs and on the mountains he was always howling and bruising himself with stones. When he saw Jesus from a distance, he ran and bowed down before him, and he shouted at the top of his voice, What have you to do with me, Jesus, Son of the Most High God? I adjure you by God, do not torment me. For he had said to him, Come out of the man, you unclean spirit. Then Jesus asked him, What is your name? He replied, My name is Legion. For we are many. he begged him earnestly not to send them out of the country. Now, there on the hillside, a great herd of swine was feeding, and the unclean spirits begged him, "Send us into the swine. Let us enter them." So he gave them permission, and the unclean spirits came out and entered the swine. And the herd, numbering about 2,000, rushed down the steep bank into the sea and were drowned in the sea. The swine herds ran off and told it in the city and in the country. Then people came to see what it was that had happened. They came to Jesus and saw the demoniac sitting there, clothed and in his right mind, the very man who had had the legion, and they were afraid. Those who had seen what had happened to the demoniac and to the swine reported it. Then they began to beg Jesus to leave their neighborhood. As he was getting into the boat, the man who had been possessed by demons begged him that he might be with him. But Jesus refused and said to him, "Go home to your friends and tell them how much the Lord has done for you and what mercy he has shown you." And he went away and began to proclaim in the Decapolis how much Jesus had done for him, and everyone was amazed. The Gospel of Christ. Praise to Christ our Lord. Quite a story, isn't it? How would you react if you were passing a cemetery early in the morning or late evening and you heard a voice in that cemetery calling out to you? One of my friends told me that on the night of the aborted Statehood Queen show at the Valley Secondary School, when tear gas filled the air, people were running in all directions. He ran too, and he found himself in St. Mary's burial ground. And he heard the voice of a young woman saying, "Mister, please carry me home." Well, he said it was a matter of come legs, don't let body perish. In a little time, he was home in Northside. In the Gospel reading for today, St. Mark tells that as soon as Jesus and his disciples reached the opposite side of the sea, a man with an unclean spirit who lived among the tombs came to Jesus. According to ancient belief, evil spirits resided among the tombs. Jesus did not run away, however. Instead, he sought to help the man. The man cried out, "What have you to do with me, Jesus, Son of the Most High God?" Throughout the Gospel narratives, we see that demons are portrayed as being terrified of Jesus. They were terribly afraid of him. They tried to dismiss Jesus as fast as they could. I am in no way saying that we are demons, but isn't it true to say that many people today try to do the very same thing? Even if they do not say it openly, they do so by their actions. "What have you to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Leave us alone. Mind your own business. This is my life, and I'm going to live it the way I want to live it." The possessed man asks, "What have you to do with me?" The answer is that Jesus had everything to do with him. Jesus said, "Come out of him." And the evil spirit came out. In like manner, Jesus has cast unclean spirits out of men and women in every generation. Spirits of greed, lust, hypocrisy, aggression. Jesus asked the unclean spirit, "What is your name?" The man replied, "My name is Legion." Now, the word legion is from Latin, and it refers to an army unit of about 4,000 to 6,000 soldiers. So Jesus did not confront one unclean spirit, but several evil spirits, and he got rid of them. How about us? When we think about ourselves, do we think that the term legion is an apt description of us? There are many of us today who are more than one person within. To our children, we are one person. To our spouse, we are another. To people in business, we are someone else. To our friends, we are yet another person. Our personalities are torn by the tension of what we are, what we seem to be, or how we seem to be to the world, and how we wish to appear. Someone once wrote, and I quote, "Each of us tends to be not a single self, but a whole committee of selves," end of quote. We are all mixtures of good and bad, clean and unclean. Jesus commanded the unclean spirit to come out of the man. It did. And as a result, a herd of pigs rushed down the steep bank into the sea. Now, there are many theories about what really happened, but we will not get into that this morning. What is fascinating is the reactions of the neighbors, the townspeople, after the man was restored to soundness of mind. One would have expected those people to rejoice over such a healing. But you see, that healing took place at the expense of their property. For most people, when it comes to a choice between people and property, they choose property. There are those who prefer to have an abundance of the world's goods, while others go hungry. So, what did the people do? They asked Jesus to leave. He was bad for business. And here I recall one Saturday morning as I stood in a bus terminal next to the market area, listening to a lady preaching. She was telling of her wonderful news about Jesus. It happened that she was standing in front of a particular vendor's stall. Customers were coming and going, but they were going to the adjacent stalls instead of his stall. And the owner of the stall where this lady was standing got real angry. He took up a weight and said to her, "Woman, if you do not move from in front of my stall talking about your Jesus, I will knock you out." She walked away, but she kept on witnessing. There are businesses Jesus is bad for. Any business which puts profits ahead of people, any business whose sole aim is to hurt people, is bad for Jesus. They began to beg Jesus to depart out of their neighborhood. People to this day resent Jesus as a disturber of the peace and an upsetter of familiar ways. Another interesting thing in this story is that when they came to Jesus and saw the demoniac sitting there clothed in his right mind, they were afraid. What is St. Mark saying to us? I think he's saying that those people could live with craziness, but not sanity. Lots of craziness is going on in our world today. Billions of dollars are being spent on making weapons of war. Billions of dollars go up in smoke as bombs are dropped each day. And millions of people are shelterless and starving. Someone has commented as they look at what is happening in our world, and I quote, "We may soon all be living among tombs," end of quote. When Jesus was asked to leave, what did he do? He left. For all his power, he does not force himself on us. But before he left, he said to the formerly possessed man, "Go home to your friends and tell them how much the Lord has done for you and what mercy he has shown you." This healing took place in Gentile country. Who were the man's friends? His friends were Gentiles. That includes us. He is the forerunner of our faith. Do we act like the townspeople who got their first real sample of sanity and could not stand it? When healing takes place amongst us, when someone who was very ill receives healing, do we praise God or are we angry about such healing? We read, "And he went away and began to proclaim in the Decapolis how much Jesus had done for him." Thanks be to God. We too are called to proclaim what Jesus has done and is doing for us. May God help us. Amen. Let us pray. The love of Christ surround you. The light of Christ lead you. The peace of Christ fill you. The joy of Christ thrill you. The presence of Christ be with you always. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you this day and always. Amen.